As of April 20th of 2025, there are currently 48 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is the same number as were erupting last week, albeit with a few changes. One of these erupting volcanoes produced an explosion loud enough to be heard in a 20-mile radius this week, specifically at Indonesia's Lewotobi volcano. Consisting of three volcanic cones, only the northern two of these have been active in historical times, with the northernmost Laki-Laki cone being the source of all 10 eruptions since 1939. This Laki-Laki cone has produced four destructive subplanean eruptions since November 2024, resulting in many surrounding settlements essentially being shelled by large lava bombs and pyroclastic flows and surges incinerating numerous square miles of surrounding terrain. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In New Zealand, increased activity at the nation's infamous White Island volcano caused its alert level to be raised from 2 to 3. Meanwhile, in Russia, a new eruption began at Kamchatka's tallest and fastest-growing volcano, the highly symmetrical complex known as Klyuchevskoy. And what is this week's top story, a major change has seemingly occurred at Alaska's Mount Spurr volcano. After an 11-month-long episode of unrest involving a confirmed intrusion of magma escalated during March 2025, it was stated that Mount Spurr was fully expected to produce a major explosive eruption later during 2025. And yet, after peaking around February 15th, multi-week average seismic activity has continuously declined at Mount Spurr, although it still remains elevated. Thus, what had been an expectation that Spurr would erupt and likely disrupt regional air traffic has now essentially lessened to a 50-50 chance, perhaps even lower than this. Volcanic gas emissions have also seemingly lowered, but there's a catch. What is true that satellite and helicopters are used to measure gas emissions, blockage by cloud cover, and poor weather can prevent collection of this data. And we have been unable to collect any verifiable gas emission data since March 21st, so theoretically speaking, gas emissions could have increased under our noses and we wouldn't know. But let's assume that gas emissions truly have decreased. This means data is trending away from Mount Spurr producing a subplanean or planean eruption, right? Not necessarily. A minority of volcanoes worldwide during unrest episodes sometimes experience a significant decline in activity in the days to weeks before they erupt, and Mount Spurr just so happens to belong to that group of volcanoes. While it may sound convoluted that both an increase and decrease in earthquakes could signal a precursor to an eruption at Mount Spurr, this is the truth. Regardless, Mount Spurr is still currently undergoing its strongest episode of unrest since it last erupted in 1992. Also, the magnitude 4.3 quake which struck near the volcano on April 18th was not volcanic, instead being triggered by the movement of the major Lake Clark fault line. In New Zealand, the White Island volcano 52 kilometers northeast of the city of Whakatane has been intermittently erupting at a low intensity since May of last year. This activity has waxed and waned, and during the last few weeks, the plume heights, number and energy involved in eruptions, maximum height of eruption plumes, and gas emissions have all increased. Some of these explosions threw large boulders of rock several hundred meters, creating an assortment of impact craters in its highly altered region. As a result, White Island's alert level was raised from 2 to 3 on a 0 to 5 scale on April 17th, the first time the volcano has been at this alert level since October 21st of last year. And in Russia, the nation's fastest growing volcano, Klyuchevskoy, erupted once again, sending a plume of ash 1,200 meters above its summit. This occurred on April 8th, and the following day, another smaller explosion occurred, ejecting a plume to about half of the same height above its summit. A third explosion occurred on April 11th, which as the largest of the group rose to an altitude of 20,000 feet. While no further activity has occurred since, in my opinion, there's a good chance that this weaker activity represents the early stages of a much longer eruption that could soon go into full force, much like seen during the initial stages of its 2019 to 2021 eruption. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on April 19th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Michael Guerin, for supporting my work.